Everyone, this is Southern Belle Whisper, and I want to make another video showing you guys another book haul video. I'd really like to make one of these videos every 2 weeks when I go to the bookstore on Thursdays. Every 2 weeks, like, go every time I get paid, because I'm trying to get my collection back. I had a huge collection when I lived in Virginia, and when we moved, I had to get rid of a bunch of books, which really broke my heart. I had like a huge collection of like the Junie B. Jones books and Little House on the Prairie books that I grew up with. And I think I told you guys last night that I'm getting over being sick, so my voice may tap out a few times in this video, but hopefully it doesn't bother you. But I will show you guys the books that I got yesterday. This is called Pieces of Mother by Melissa Castro. It's a story. I really like true books. Books that are based on true stories. And this one looked really good. It says, one summer, Melissa Castro's mother drove off without explanation. Devastated, Melissa and her brothers were left to pick up the pieces, always tormented by the thought, why did their mother abandon them? 36 years later, with children of her own, Melissa finds herself in Olympia, Washington, as her mother is dying. After decades of hiding her painful memories, she is just dazed to find out what happened that summer and confront the fear she might have a leaving Jean. But Melissa never expects to stumble across a cache of letters her mother wrote to her but never sent. Letters that could hold the answers she seeks. Haunting yet ultimately uplifting, Pieces of My Mother chronicles one woman's quest to discover how our parents' choices impact our own and how we can survive those choices to forge our own paths. About that one. And then this one I was reading to you guys last night. It's Come As You Are, The Story of Nevada. And like I said, this book has a lot of cool pictures in it of Kurt and Dave and a really cool book to have for anybody that loves Nirvana. I grew up with Nirvana. Hey, yummy. I grew up in the 90s, so I grew up with a lot of Nirvana's music. And I was heartbroken when Kurt died. I was really young, but I still felt the sting of losing such a great musician. So yeah, there's that one. And then this is the one I'm reading right now. it's called Would Rabbit House by Judy Chase. I will put right here, and yes, I dog ear my book, so I wish I didn't do that. Maybe here, I'll do this one. Put the book right there. There we go. It's a very interesting book. I really like it. I'm about right there on it. I'm trying not to. There is another book over here that I'm dying to read. I'm trying not to read two books at the same time. I won't be able to get engrossed in the book and not have myself thinking about what's going to happen in the next chapter of the other book I'm reading. So I'm reading this one at the moment. It's really good. And I read the back to you. This is the one that I am excited about. It's called The Nightingale by Christine Hanna. Kristen Hanna. I have heard so much about how amazing this book is. And it's pretty thick. It's about, I'd say about 400-500 pages. It sounds amazing. It's got all these awards. And then at the bottom it says, with courage, grace, and powerful insight, best-selling author Christine Hanna captures the epic paranormal of World War II and eliminates an intimate part of history seldom seen, the Women's War. The Nightingale tells the stories of two sisters separated by years of experience, by ideals, passion, and circumstance, each embarking on her own dangerous path towards survival, love, and freedom in German-occupied, war-torn France. A breathtakingly beautiful novel that celebrates the resilience of the human spirit and the durability of women. It is a novel for everyone, a novel for a lifetime. So I am super excited about reading this. This is the one I'm going to read next after the Moon Rabbit House when I finish that one. This looks like an amazing book. I'm so excited about reading it. And it's not a true book, but everybody knows that the Holocaust and the Nazis and World War II really did happen, so it's in a way based on real events. It's just the characters are fictional, kind of like Titanic. We all know that Titanic sank back in 1912, but we all know that Rose and Jack were fictional characters. Give a love story to the story, and that's why it's one of my favorite movies of all time. But yes, I can't wait to read this. So yes, that is my book haul. These are the books I got. My book haul, and I can't wait to have my own house one day where I can have a little library set up with all my favorite books on it. Alright, you guys, I just thought I'd show you all the books I got. But I will talk to you guys later. Bye bye. Oh, actually, if you would like me to read any of these books right here, the night.